For an opportunity to be here at Pleasant Grove, amen. I am Pastor Audwin Lance Millican, amen. You can call me Lance, a little fat ball head man, I love Jesus. We have to thank God right now for this opportunity this morning to come before you. We thank God for all the officers here in the church, for everyone that is attended here. Somebody just say to Lottie, Dottie, and everybody, amen. We just thank God. For you too, my wife, amen. Lady D, who we call belovedly Lady D in Arcadia. And we just thank God for her.
Amen.
We thank God for the church that I pastor the most, that I preach at the most. Amen. New Beginnings Ministry of Arcadia. They wanted to have service on this morning. I say go right ahead. Amen. It's something how you can lead and still carry on and still be a leader. And I just thank God. That shows your leadership that when you're not there, it's still being led. And I just thank God. If you have your Bibles with you, amen, it won't be very long because it doesn't take everlasting to do eternal things. Amen. The book of Judges, amen. The book of Judges, with not a familiar passage of scripture, but just want to bring it into your knowledge of biblical intake. Amen. The third chapter of the book of Judges, amen, round about the 31st verse. Amen. One of those passages of scripture that I hope we can hear from and glean from in what God is saying. Amen. When you have it, just say amen.
Amen.
On the book of Judges, the third chapter, and I'll be reading from you from the New Living Translation. Amen. The 31st verse. And it says this: after Ehud, Shamgar, the son of Net, rescued Israel, and he once killed 600 Philistines with an ox bull. The word of the Lord is already blessed. We just want to speak into your ears on today. Deliver me. Amen. Deliver me. There was one George Moore, who is an 18th century theologian, and he says this: the more I am in a position to be tried in faith with reference to my body, my family, my service, and for the Lord, my business, etc., the more shall I have the opportunity of seeing God's help and deliverance.
Yeah.
Every fresh instance in which he helps and delivers me will tend towards the increase of my faith.
Yeah.
That's what George Moeller said, the 18th century preacher, stated this, and he said this because the more my faith is tried, the more my faith increases. You got to understand that as long as I'm being tried on every side, my faith is being increased.
Yeah.
As long as I'm here, I'm being tested, my faith is being increased. It was God who, at the point of antiquity, raised up the judges to deliver Israel from bondage. Here in the book of Judges, we find that God did some things in the land. There was three that he raised up. If we go to the first part of the third chapter, it was three that he raised up. One named Othniel, the other Ehud, and the last Shamgar.
Yeah.
You know how God always does things in triplicate. I don't know about you, but there's sometimes we do things in triplicate. He is a trichotomy of what God is, because he's mighty, mind, and soul. That's how man is made up. The trichotomy of man is made up: mind, body, and soul. Here it is that the kingdom of heaven, the Godhead, is made up of Father, Son, and Spirit. Here it is that when he talks about delivering Israel, he brings out three young men: Othniel, Ehud, and Shamgar. One of the things that we have to find out is that every one of them had very realistic characteristics. I thank God for Othniel, because Othniel did some things that brought Israel to the place, because it was something. There's a little written about here. Othniel was a significant Kizite, and he delivered Israel from the fortress of an impenetrable, but from some standard, a fortress that was impenetrable. The Bible here is their, one of their descendants that said he had to go and deliver Israel from the hands of the enemy. Yeah. I don't know about you today, but I'm tried on every side because the enemy tries to attack me every day. Yeah. And you got to understand that he's trying to deliver me out of the hands of the clutches of the enemy. Oh, anybody being delivered today, I have to fight against the devil every day because the devil tries to come steal, kill, and destroy. Earlier, the distinction talks about how he was captured in the bier because the bier was this fortress that the children of Israel were in captivity with. And I thank God today that we find out that God raised up judges. I don't know about you, but there's some judges around there. There's some people around in your life. Amen. They're trying to bring you out of the attack of the enemy. And I thank God I'm here today to bring Pleasant Grove out of the attack of the enemy. Deliver me, Lord. Deliver me out of the hands of the enemy. He delivered them out of the bondage. He helped them in several different ways and attacks of the enemy. Then here comes Ehud. You got to understand, here's another character that God brought up, this judge that was left-handed. Oh, it's something about left-handed people. You know, a lot of right-handed people say left-handed people are awkward. It mentioned in the Bible that he could not use his right hand, so he had to use his left hand. And in his left hand, he would deliver Israel out of some enemy attacks. I thank God for Ehud because Ehud did some things with the king of Eglon, the Moabite king. He delivered Israel from that because he snuck up on him with his left hand and stabbed him with a dagger. Oh, I don't know about you, but there are some people that will come to you face to face and try to take you out. There's some people and attacks that are coming to you from every kind of way, but you got to understand how to fight the devil. And anybody understand how to fight the enemy? God is raising up some people to fight the enemy, and I thank God for Ehud, because Ehud took him and he brought them back out of the city of Moab.
Yeah.
And he brought them to this place, but he was left-handed. I thank God for left-handed people, because every now and then there's something I can do with a left-handed person.
Yeah.
I thank God for when I looked at baseball. It's hard to hit a left-handed pitcher. Oh, y'all ain't gotta say that. Yeah. Can I talk for a minute, brother?
Yeah.
It's hard to hit a left-handed pitcher. And if you understand that left-handed pitchers throw from an angle that right-handed batters can't hit from, it's something how it comes to you. But not only that, but I thank God for left-handed basketball players. Oh, you ain't got to say that. It's hard to defend the basketball when you're used to going to the right side.
Yeah.
But now here it is that I'm shooting from the left side. Here it is that King Eglon did not see Ehud coming. Because the Bible tells us that Ehud made a dagger and he slipped up on Eglon and stabbed him in the chest to take him out and to move him out of the way of the children of Israel. I thank God that God will give us weapons. Y'all ain't gotta say that. Because the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty in the pulling down of strongholds. Oh, you ain't understanding what I'm saying. You gotta understand that God uses something that are simple to us, but it's complicated to the wise. You gotta understand what God is doing. If I can, here it is that he finds himself being this left hand, and before taking Israel tribute to Eglon, he brought this dagger and assassinated him, the unsuspecting Eglon, during a private conversation. And he rallied the Israelites to the west of Jordan to encircle the Moabite troops and to bring them into captivity. Well, I got to come down to my last character. My last character is Shamgar. And the scripture text tells us today that Shamgar slew 600 people with the end of an ox gall. Yeah, some of y'all might be saying, what is an ox guard? What in the devil is an ox guard? Well, an ox guard is a staff that was used to move cows and cattle around. It's just like the staff that Moses had in his hand. Oh, you ain't got to say that. It's just like the staff that the shepherds carried. But the only thing about it, it had a point on the end. Yes. Because you got to understand that oxen were big, strong animals.
Yes.
And they had to be moved certain kind of ways. They had to be moved different kind of ways. And I thank God today that sometimes we got to be moved to the direction of God for him to deliver us out of the hand of the enemy. So many times we've gotten off track and we moved the way we wanted to move. But God needed to put us back in line. So he took an ox cord and put us back in line. But with the same ox cord that he put us back in line with, he defeated my enemy. Oh, you ain't got to say that. I dare you to high five your neighbor. I said, neighbor, God is using Shamrock to bring me out. God is using someone to deliver me out of the hands of the enemy. God is using Pastor Millican to talk about the hands of the enemy. Deliver me from sickness and shame. Deliver me from the hands of the enemy. Deliver me. Wasn't significant in what he was doing, but it was what he used that helped him. Oh, let me help you here. Let me give you a little background. It was Moses that stood at the Red Sea. Oh, you got to hear the word.
Yeah.
It was Moses that stood at the Red Sea, and God told him, use. Oh, my God. Yeah, I got some Bible for you. He said, use what's in your hand. Not only that, but I remember the psalmist writer said, with his rod and his staff, he comforted me.
Yeah.
Oh, God, I got to say that. I thank God for what God is doing. But here's Shamgar, use it to fight. Oh, I'm sorry. Let me come over here. Can I come over here? I don't mind if I use this microphone, if it ever worked for me. But it is simply how God can use Shamgar and the oxen of the gourd, or the gourd oxen, or the ox gourd, to get us where we need to go.
Uh-huh.
Oh, let me come back over here. Y'all ain't paying attention. See, the thing about it is, a lot of times we try to step out and do it on our own. But God says, get back in line. Get back in formation. Because you got to understand, there's a solidity in formation. Oh, my God. Get down. Let me come back right here with a preacher, Pastor Hicks. Hicks, he'll tell me. He said, sometimes you got to get back in formation. Because when you get in formation, then you become strong. Oh, you ain't got to say that. I'm weak when
I'm over here by myself. I'm weak when I'm over here alone. But when I get in formation,
oh, y'all ain't got to tell me that.
When I get in formation, God allows me to get some strength. Oh, I'm sorry. I mean, it seems like somewhere in Pleasant Grove, we ain't in formation. Oh, I ain't talking about the church. Well, I'm talking about with God. Because a lot of times, we got to get ourselves right with God before we get back in formation. Because God has sent some people to help us out of the hand of the enemy.
Yeah.
But we have not seen the things that God has done. Because some people might have been left-handed.
Oh, I'm sorry. Let me come back over here.
I said, Baptist folk don't like left-handed folk.
No. Oh, my God.
See, it's something about we don't like left-handed people.
Now, I ain't talking about, all right, y'all got it now. I ain't talking about broke-handed people. I'm talking about left-handed people.
Because there's sometimes we don't like the way you do things. We don't like the way you preach. We don't like the way you teach. And when we don't like that, we try to put our own critique on.
Amen.
Can I talk about Ms. Hayes? A lot of times, we try to put our own critique on it, and we need to do it like we used to do.
Mm-hmm.
But baby, this ain't no time to do it like we used to do. We live in a day and time, things are done differently.
Uh-huh.
And the thing about it is, we used to be quiet and sit there.
Mm-hmm.
But let me show you something. When you're under construction, it's noise. When there's some work going on, it's noise.
Yeah.
When there's some things going on, you ain't got
live.
Yes.
But let me say this right now, and I'm about to come to a close. It was Shamgar that did some things. He was a son of Anita, and two brief references. There are only two scriptures in the whole Bible about Shamgar. One is in Judges, the third chapter. The other one is in the fifth chapter and the sixth verse. But there's one thing that he did. He gave a major contribution because the children of Israel were about to be defeated. And the thing that he did, he brought them together and he said, look, I'm going to fight off the enemy.
Yeah.
Oh, y'all ain't got to say it. My most wolf, utmost enemy. And that utmost enemy was the Philistine. And he said he fought off the Philistine with the end of an ox goad.
Yes.
And he slayed 600.
Yeah.
Wow. Wow.
See, let me help y'all. And I'm about to be through. If one can put 1,000 in a flight, two can put 10,000 in a flight. So if we get in formation and start praying together, watch God. Watch God defeat our enemy. See, because we ain't walking around with no oxfords no more. You got a cell phone. And see, y'all like to take pictures and videos and everything. And if something's going on, somebody needs some help. You taking a video. It's a fight going on. You ain't stopping the fight. You taking a video. Somebody drunk out of their mind. YouTube. And that's the thing that we ought to do. We ought to quit being spectators and start being participants. We ought to quit being spectators and living on everybody else's demise and start lifting them up. Because you gotta understand what he was saying. He said, I and I be lifted up. I draw all men unto me. And you gotta understand that we gotta give God the glory. When we give him the glory, he's gonna fight our battles. He's gonna bring somebody to our help. He's gonna deliver me out of the hand of the enemy. See, I don't know about you, but I need deliverance every day. I need deliverance every day. Because the devil tries to attack me in my health, in my wealth, on my job. He tries to attack me all kind of ways. In my church, in the pews. He tries to attack us every day. But I need him to deliver me. I need an Othiel. I need an Ephod. And then I need a Shamgar in my life. I need the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost in my life today. See, I thank God for that. Because as a New Testament church, that's what we ought to have. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. See, and those three are at one. See, I don't need a whole lot of people to fight my battle. That's why I wanted to use Shamgar. All he needed was the end of an ox goad to fight his battle. All I need is the Holy Ghost to help me fight my battle. So I thank God today. I thank God for the story of these judges, how they delivered Israel out of the hand of the enemy. I thank God today that he brought us from a mighty long way. But we still got a long way to go. It's something how God does. And if we understand how God is using us in this New Testament time, if we understand that it ain't the old way, but it's what God said. Yes, I know. I understand it was simpler that back then. It was easier back then. But have you dealt with some of the complicated demons that we got to deal with today? I heard the Sunday school teacher say, some of us need some therapy. Say, we need a therapist to tell our troubles to, to talk to. So every now and then, I need somebody to lean on in my time of distress. I need somebody to talk to when it gets hard. I even heard Sister Hayes say, I call you, but I don't see you every now and then. See, that's what we ought to start doing. Don't quit being nosy with that cell phone. trouble. Yeah. Every now and then, he's going to give me just what I need the most. Yeah. And I don't know about you today, but I thank God for sending me some help to deliver me from the hands of the enemy.
Yeah.
I thank God.
Amen.
See, I thank God today.
Amen.
See, it doesn't take everlasting to do eternal things.
Yeah.
But I thank God that he showed me that I sent you some help in your time of trouble.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Now all you got to do is call on and call on your help.
Yeah.
Call on when you need them the most.
Yeah.
It looks like the fortress is impenetrable, but God got somebody to use.
Yes.
It looks like every time you go to throw something at the devil, he hits it out of the park.
Uh-huh.
Get a left-handed pitcher and throw a ball at it. Every now and then he tries to get me to get out of line.
Uh-huh.
And some of us need the oxygen to put us back in line.
Yeah.
Right off the dangers of the enemy.
Yeah.
And I thank God today. There may be one here today.
Yes.
There may be someone here today. Hallelujah. That needs God. That needs the help of these three judges in that line. Because I don't know about you, but every day I need God to help me.
Yes,
every day I need him to help me out of the situations that I'm in.
Yes.
Every day I need him to help me, to guide me along the straight and narrow. Because he said, if I just lean not to my own understanding, but in all my ways acknowledge him, he's going to direct my path. He's going to lead me to the truth. He's going to lead me to the best. He's going to lead me to healing. He's going to lead me to my deliverance. And you may need God today. There may be some things that are going on in your life today that you need him to deliver you out of. Some impenetrable fortresses. Some things that I can't get. But I need God to do it for me.